Hey guys, today we're going to be taking a look at Valheim and seeing how we can make a nice looking boar pen. If you're anything like me and watched a couple guides on how to tame boars, or you just kind of jumped into it yourself, then you no doubt use the wooden fencing to make a pen and to tame them in. However, as I look at this pen, it really bothers me how crappy and ghetto it looks. I threw a door on it so I could get in and out a little smoother than just jumping over the fences, but that just looks even more out of place. So today we're going to be going through how we go from a pin that looks like this to a nice boar pin that looks like this. Now constructing the pin itself is actually fairly simple. Place a workbench down, obviously, level out the ground, and place down one of the 2-meter horizontal wood beams. In order to make it a nice circle, every wood beam you place to the side of it should be rotated by one notch. And then you will add the wood roof cross at 45 degree angles on top of each beam. And continue this pattern until you have a complete circle. It is definitely possible to design this pin with the same pieces and make it a square or rectangle, but in order to achieve a circle, it's probably going to have to be in this pattern to keep the same symmetrical shape. Once you've completed the circle of wood beams, you can simply place a door on whichever side you'd like your entrance to be, and then make sure you level out the ground a little bit more inside so there are no gaps along the bottoms of the wood beams. And then you will add a set of stairs outside of your door so that you can easily walk inside of the pen. Now be sure that you leave the inside of the door without any stairs because the ledge of the wood beam will actually prevent boars from escaping. So once you trap some inside, you can freely use the door without having to worry about boars slipping out during the taming process. Now you can also do this entire pen with the short 26 degree wood roof crosses and the boars will still not escape it. If you prefer this look, to have a little bit shorter of a pin, it does operate just fine with the exception of the door not being the same height, but that might not particularly bother you. If you would like to spruce up your boar pin just a little bit, you can use 2 more wood beams and the angled 26 degree wall pieces to make a feeding trough, and then add yourself a slight walkway with stairs up to it, 3 spaces away from it, and whenever you throw food out of your inventory, it will land directly in the feeding trough. And addition number 2 you can add is a angled roof piece, and maybe add some pylons onto it to give the boar some shelter, although I know the game does not actually have them need it. It's nice to go that extra mile for your little boars. And in case you were wondering, yes, it actually does provide shelter. Now, I had my daughter watching me build this small shelter here, and she pointed out that I could simply remove a single wall piece and give them an actual indoor shelter. So I gave this a shot, making a 2x3 shelter off of one edge of the boar pen and roofing it up, and yes, this does indeed work and looks pretty decent, giving the boar somewhere to hide from the rain so you can feel like you're properly taken care of. Now the one thing that is not included in this guide for this boar pen is a efficient water trough, because just like everything else in Valheim, boars do not actually require water to stay alive. I highly suspect that if we ever get far enough in Valheim to see Odin himself, he will in fact be played by Denzel Washington.
Water is for cowards. Water makes you weak.
Now you might be wondering, with all the walls closed up on this boar pen, how exactly you get boars into it. As we've already discussed, they cannot cross over the wood beams, so we cannot bring them in through the door, but you do gain back all your materials when you destroy something, so we are simply going to destroy 1 or 2 wall pieces, and just as you would with wood pole fences, lure a boar inside, and then quickly trap that exit with wood pole fences. Now the nice part about these materials is even if you put the pole fences directly in your building path, you can still build through them and rebuild up your boar pen while they are in the way. If you are looking to capture multiple boars, then just lure one to one edge of the boar pen and trap it there with the wood pole fences, break open the wall again, and rinse and repeat. If you're wondering how you are going to get your current boars, if you already have them, into this new pen, we are gonna cover that as well. Now it's already known, and Firespark has gone over this before, that you can move boar by going unarmed, going into a block stance, and simply sliding tamed boar over, but that would take a while when you have multiple boars. So instead we will create a small alleyway with the pole fences from one pin to another. Go ahead and destroy the one section of wall from the new pin. And then we are going to place down a few torches. The torches are going to put the boars in a frightened state, making them charge all over the place. Now the boars, both when they're attacking you and are frightened, have a tendency to charge one direction, circle around in some way, and charge back the other direction. So this is all about timing. Whenever you get the boars to move through the tunnel, start just slowly placing wall fences and shortening their area. And then every time they charge farther, add another one until you have them successfully in the pen. This method with the fire is obviously very chaotic, but as you can see here, I managed to get it done without too much hassle with like 7 boars or 6 boars or something. Now, it's also been discussed that boars will not sufficiently breed if they are too cramped and have too many in the area. So there will be some experimentation on finding out how many boars can actually live comfortably in this circular pen. But if you're looking to have a whole lot more boars and run a big pig farm here, then you might want to go with a square or a rectangle and make it whatever size you would like. Another thing to keep in mind is you must have a workbench in the area in order to build a pen. If this pen is far enough from your main workbench, you will have to construct a second one. I am not a fan of having another random workbench sitting in the field, so what you can do is replace the workbench underneath your little walkway for feeding and wall it completely in, allowing you to build in the area and construct anything else you might need in this area, but not having the eyesore of another workbench without any improvements. Well guys, there you go. There is a slightly better looking boar pen if you were getting tired of the rickety looking fences and you wanted something a little more neat and professional looking. The cross beams used for this pen are designed for roofing, so they should not decay in the rain, but I cannot guarantee that as of yet. So make sure you're checking on them periodically, especially after taming boars, to make sure that they're not damaged. Hopefully this little guide was helpful for you to get a little bit more of a professional look around your home base. Thanks for watching, I will see you next time.